Hello, welcome back to my page and channel. As a personal trainer and exercise specialist, I don't believe in temporary and quick fixes. I am very passionate about equipping and empowering you so that you can achieve your goals through lifestyle changes. We are busy with the intermittent fasting series and we're talking about intermittent fasting and diabetes. So where does intermittent fasting fit into all this? Well, it boils down to insulin resistance. If insulin resistance is developed because we force certain things on the body, then the moment we stop forcing it, then it will start returning to homeostasis. It's as simple as that. Our body will return to balance. So what does it mean then to stop the factors? It means to eat less of the foods that stimulates insulin, foods like sugars, refined carbs, and processed starches. The more we eat these foods, the more insulin we stimulate. So the whole idea is to eat less of the foods that stimulate insulin so that you can reverse insulin resistance and become more insulin sensitive and help the body burn off the fuel and find blood sugar balance again. So you can help your body to find blood sugar balance again by doing those things. So eat moderate to very little fruit if you're already insulin resistant. Cut out grains, both processed and complex, because there's very little difference in the blood sugar impact. Start eating more natural fats, moderate protein, and more whole foods because they have the fiber and they have the whole package of what you need. If you start eating low carb and low sugar and this works for you, then intermittent fasting is going to work even better and faster, because when you're fasting, you are not eating anything, and then your carb intake is zero, which means no insulin spikes. This is a good tool to reduce insulin response. You also need to eat less frequently, because if you eat something that stimulates insulin and you eat 3 to 6 times, then you are pushing insulin 3 to 6 times. You are giving the cell 3 to 6 reasons to become insulin resistant. So the longer that you go without meals, the greater opportunity the cell has to start burning through some of that fuel. You can check out on my video on the different intermittent fasting plans and you can see which one works for you. So type 2 diabetics who have high blood sugar but who is not on any medication, they may go ahead with intermittent fasting, but please, you need to consult with your doctor. You need to do this under the supervision of your doctor. So start by going low carb and low sugar to ease your body into intermittent fasting. And if intermittent fasting is the fastest, most powerful way to start bringing your insulin down and reversing it. So that's why you want to do intermittent fasting, because you want to bring your insulin down and eventually reverse it, but do it gradually. And like I said, please check out my video on the different plans, see how your body responds and see how it works for you. Play around and you can find the one that works the best for you. So if you are a type 2 diabetic and you are taking metformin or a similar drug, you may go ahead with intermittent fasting, but also I can't overemphasize this enough, it needs to be under the supervision of your doctor. You need to check in with him and let him know what you are doing. So there are a few things to consider though. Because if you all of a sudden take all the carbs out of your diet and you keep the same level of medication, it probably won't happen super fast, but there's a chance that the medication can drive your blood sugar too low to suddenly. So you want to monitor the, you need to monitor this very, very carefully. Monitor your glucose level and watch it very closely. You need to consult with your doctor so that they know what you're doing. Please, they need to know what you're doing. And you can talk to your doctor about how much metformin to take and so forth. So if you are a type 2 diabetic and you're on metformin and or insulin, so if you're on one or the other or you're on both, then I would strongly recommend that you talk to your doctor first before doing this and talk about how to dose those insulin levels, because there are concerns with hypoglycemia. And hypoglycemia is also known as low blood sugar. It is a drop in blood sugar to levels below normal. So basically, what's going to happen if you're on certain levels of carbs and certain levels of insulin, and then you cut out all carbs like all of a sudden, now you're going to be over-medicated, and there's a good chance that you're going to push that blood sugar too low and develop hypoglycemia. So as a diabetic, if the insulin is only there to handle the carbs that you are eating, then if you reduce the carbs, why not just reduce the insulin dose and monitor it very carefully? Most of the complications of both type 1 and type 2 diabetics is because they are really mismanaged. Some diabetics have blood sugar swings because the more sugar and the more carbs that you eat, the more blood sugar swings you are going to have, because carbs promote glucose. So you are going to get the best blood sugar levels when you are fat adapted, because now you have very, very few blood sugar swings. So you can check out my video on fat adaption as well, where I explain that in much more detail. So your body has learned to depend on fat and ketones for fuel instead of carb, and that's a good thing. So that's when you are fat adapted, because you depend less on the glucose that is produced by carbs. Not only will you need less insulin, but you're going to have much less sugar swings. So that's going to make it much easier in the long run to reduce insulin resistance. So when you reduce the carbs and the sugars, you won't have that sugar swings, and your body will start depending on the ketones for fuel. And then in the long run, that's what will reduce your insulin resistance. So if you're a type 1 diabetic who has eaten lots of carbs and your insulin dose has been going up over time, you also may go ahead with intermittent fasting, but consult with your doctor, under the supervision of your doctor. If you want to start slower and gradually go low carb sugar, then it would be much easier for you to figure out to progressively change your medication, but realize that as soon as you cut back on your carbs, you are over medicated. So you need to consult with your doctor when doing this. You have to change both of them, you know, to match them together. You have to change the food, the carb intake, and the insulin dose at the same time. The reason for doing this is because both blood sugar and insulin are very destructive. They are both very damaging. There are a lot of complications related to insulin resistance and diabetes, such as blindness, kidney failure, cardiovascular disease, obesity, and even amputations. So see how intermittent fasting works for you, and be mindful of how you feel, and remain aware of the early signs of hypoglycemia. Please, you need to remain aware of this. Signs like lightheadedness. You know, if you do feel hypoglycemic, be willing to break the fasting window if needed. Your health must always come first. And to those who are new to intermittent fasting, especially if they're coming on the, especially if you are on a high glycemic diet, you may feel the pangs of hunger, you may feel fatigue, headaches, because your body is adjusting to the new source of fuel. Your body is adjusting from carbs as a fuel to ketones as a fuel. And please remember, you need to do this under the supervision of your doctor or healthcare provider so that you can get good guidance in monitoring, measuring, and regulating. So I'd like to thank you for joining me today. And please comment or send me messages if you have any questions. And it's always an absolute pleasure to be with you. So always, always remember, you can achieve all your goals through commitment, discipline, and perseverance. I'll see you in the next video.